हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। दिस इज शिखा संबरकर एंड टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क पार्ट 11। अंडर दिस देयर इज अ सब टॉपिक ट्रांसमिशन मीडिया पार्ट 7 एंड अंडर दैट टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट अनगाइडेड मीडिया सैटेलाइट। यस, सैटेलाइट दिस इज अवर टॉपिक। दिस वीडियो इज हेल्पफुल फॉर क्लास 12th CBSE स्टूडेंट्स, दोज हु हैव ऑप्टेड कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स प्रैक्टिसेस एज एन ऑप्शनल सब्जेक्ट। And those who are interested in this field, computer network, they also can watch this video. So let's start our topic, satellite. So before starting the topic, first we should know what is the meaning of transmission media. Here you can see one image, one sender PC is there and one receiver PC is there. Sender PC is placed in the left top corner, and receiver it is another side. So sender PC we can say source PC, and receiver PC we can say destination PC, destination system. So from sender to receiver we can send messages via transmission media. From sender to receiver we can send messages through transmission media, and this transmission media can be wired or wireless. So here we are going to discuss about wireless transmission media. So there are some points are given. Wireless transmission media, under that we will discuss today about satellite. You can watch my previous videos. There I have discussed about guided media and unguided media. Here two points are given. The cables that connect two or more workstations are the communication channels. Two or more workstations. Workstations are simply systems. Systems or PCs. If a separate PC is connected with a network, at that time that particular PC is called workstation or node. Communication channels are also called transmission media or connecting media. So this is the concept of transmission media. Transmission media. Here, types of transmission media. We can group a transmission media in two categories, guided and unguided. The guided media includes cables. Unguided media includes waves through air, water or vacuum. The basic types of guided media are twisted pair cable, coaxial cable and fiber optics. And basic types of unguided media are infrared, radio wave, microwave, satellite. So today here in this video we will discuss about satellite. So let's start our topic, satellite. Here you can see three images are given. All are the images of satellite. Here three images you can see. I have included these images so that you can understand how it looks like satellite. This is nothing but just a device. So satellite means what? First we should know what's the meaning of this word satellite. Satellite means what? We can say A natural object moving around a larger object. A natural object, we can say the moon. Moon, it's a natural object, and moving around the larger object, we can say the earth. So here, a natural object moving around a larger object in space, that is called satellite in general. Or we can say an artificial object. An artificial object we can say man-made object or a device, or we can say an artificial object sent up into space to travel around the earth, that is also called satellite. So in general here we can understand it like that an artificial body placed in orbit around the earth. An artificial body or device placed in orbit around the earth or moon or another planet in order to collect information or for communication, that is called a satellite. So this is the concept of satellite. Actually, there are two major types of satellites, are natural and second one is artificial. There are two types, natural one and artificial. Natural satellite, we can say the moon. The moon is a satellite because it moves around Earth. That's why we can say the moon is a natural satellite. And artificial means what? Artificial object sent up into space to travel around the Earth or any other planet. So that is artificial one. And there are different types of satellites are available as per their use, as per their working. You can understand it like communication satellite, remote sensing, navigation satellite, and drone satellite, and so many satellites are there. Geocentric orbit type satellite, global positioning system GPS, that is also, and geostationary satellites, polar satellites, nano satellites. There are so many satellites are there in the space. And major types, there are two main types, are natural and man-made or artificial. So natural one means the moon. We can say the moon is a natural satellite. And I have told you that communication satellite, we can say that communication satellite is a artificial one. So this is the concept of satellite. Now you can see three images are given here. All these three are showing the that device, that artificial device, that that we can say that satellite or artificial object. So here one thing is common in the all these three images, that solar wing or solar panel. Here in all these three images, you can see one thing is common, that blue wings of that device, both the sides of the device, you can see that blue kind of panel or wing. So that is called solar wing or solar panel. You can see both the sides of this device. Both the sides are attached with this solar wing or solar panel. So it is attached here so that the satellite can run properly. This is the one of the part of this satellite, we can say. And apart from this, batteries are also installed in this satellite so that in absence of sunlight, satellite can work properly. So this is the important part of this satellite. And there are so many important parts or subparts, we can say. And one more important part is transponder. It is also a part of this satellite, and it is mainly used in satellite communication to transfer the received signals. It is mainly used in satellite communication to transfer the received signals. So this is the general meaning and images of the satellite. There are two types. We can understand that natural one and artificial one. Natural one, we can understand that moon is the natural one satellite, and artificial one, there are so many artificial satellites are available, like communication satellites. So this is the concept of satellite. Here you can see images of satellite launching programs. You can see these three images are given. I think you have seen all this kind of images in TV or using your mobiles or any other laptop or computer device. Whenever the programs are launched, this kind of images you have seen on your devices. So this are the images of satellite launching programs, and ISRO. ISRO is a Indian Space Research Organization. We all are aware about this. So I have included these images so that you can recall these things. Here two images are given. Both are showing the same concept. You can see how the satellites or an artificial object, satellites or an artificial object is moving around the earth. You can see how the satellites are moving around the earth. So there are so many satellites are moving around the earth. You can see the images here. Here you can see the images of antennas and tower. It is used for satellite communication. You can see these three images are given, how the antennas are used and signals are transmitted from satellite to these antennas. You can see the images of this antennas. Now the working of satellite. Here you can see two images. Both are showing the working of this satellite. So a satellite is a body that moves around another body in a particular path. As we all are aware that satellite is a body, or we can say it's a device that moves around another body or another device in a particular path. So a communication satellite is nothing but a microwave repeater station in a space. We can say this communication satellite, it's like a microwave repeater station in a space. It means in a space this satellite is nothing but like a microwave repeater station, and it is helpful in telecommunication, radio and television along with internet application. Now repeater circuit which increases the strength of the received signal. What's the work of repeater? Repeater increases the strength of the received signal and then transmits it. But this repeater works as a transponder. And you can see here in the left side image, uplink and downlink. First earth station, then uplink, then satellite, then downlink, then second earth station. So here you can see the frequency with which the signal is sent into the space from first earth station to satellite. You can see in the picture, in the image, from first earth station to the satellite, the link is sent. So the frequency with which the signal is sent into the space is called as uplink frequency. Similarly, the frequency with which the signal is sent by the transponder, that satellite, that repeater, that is transponder. So the frequency with which the signal is sent by the transponder is called as downlink frequency. So it is clear here that from the first earth station to satellite, once signals can be sent, and there in that device, in that object satellite, there is a subpart transponder, and it will retransmit that signal to second earth station, and that is called downlink. This is the concept of uplink and downlink. Uplink from earth station to satellite. From first earth station to satellite, you are sending the messages. And satellite, in that satellite device, in that satellite object, there is a subpart transponder. And that transponder will send it or transmit it to second earth station. And that is called downlink. So this is the concept or working here. Here latency, in the right side you can see the image, that image is also showing the same concept and the latency period. Latency period is 0.5 second. It means within a second, the receiver will receive the message. The receiver will receive the message. That is called latency period. I have discussed about this in my previous videos also. Latency means, okay. Now there are some points related to satellite. First point is, in satellite communication, the earth station consists of a satellite dish that functions as an antenna. As we have seen in our previous images, that antenna. In satellite communication, the earth station consists of a satellite dish that functions as an antenna and communication equipment to transmit and receive data from satellites passing overhead. So we have seen this images in our in my previous slides in this video. Second point is, a number of communication satellites owned by both governments and private organizations have been placed in stationary orbits about 22,300 miles above the Earth's surface. Third point, these satellites act as relay stations for communication signals. The satellites accept data or signals transmitted from an Earth station, amplify them and retransmit them to another Earth station. We have seen this concept in the previous slide, in the previous image. Using such a setup, data can be transmitted to the other side of the Earth in only one step. Within a second, we can receive the messages. So, this is the concept here. Now, some more points related to satellite. First is, most communication satellites have multiple independent reception and transmission devices, known as transponders. We have seen the concept of transponders in the previous images. In a commercial communication satellite, a single transponder is visually capable of handling a full color commercial television transmission complete with audio. Transponders for data transmission may be even larger. Some firms that market satellite communication service own a satellite. Others lease a portion of a satellite and provide transmission facilities in smaller units to ultimate users. The security is visually provided by the coding and decoding equipment. So, these are the concepts here. Now, some advantages of satellite. First point, the area coverage is quite large. The area coverage is quite large. Second is, the laying and maintenance of intercontinental cable is difficult and expensive. And this is where the satellite proves to be the best alternative. Third point, the heavy usage of intercontinental traffic makes the satellite commercially attractive. Fourth point, satellites can cover large areas of the Earth. This is particularly useful for sparsely populated areas. These are the advantages. Now some disadvantages. Disadvantages of satellite. First is, technological limitations preventing the deployment of large high-gain antennas on the satellite platform. Second is, overcrowding of available bandwidths due to low antenna gains. Third is, the high investment cost and insurance cost associated with significant probability of failure. Fourth is, high atmospheric losses above 30 gigahertz limit carrier frequencies. So, these are some disadvantages of satellite. So, here we have seen the concept of satellite. I hope this video is helpful for you all. Please like, share, comment and subscribe this YouTube channel presented by Shikha Sambarkar. Thank you.